setting of the show, San Francisco?
Yeah, set in San Francisco.
How do you feel about that city?
I love San Francisco. I haven't spent that much time there. We actually shoot in Vancouver.
Oh, okay. Right,
it's just set in San Fran, and there's some exterior shots that happen there, but for the most part, we're on a studio, and we're working on it around Vancouver.
Sure, sure. Can you maybe tell us, I understand, your producer is talking about how you're not there to play the character in a kind of bitchy way and that kind of thing. Who have you looked at that is maybe like a similar character? In seeing some of the previews, reminded me a bit of like some of Joan Crawford's kind of roles, where she's, has to be so in control of herself.
Interesting. That's really lovely. I've actually just tried to draw from some people in my personal life. And I find the characters the most interesting in these old movies, new movies, whatever. I find characters most interesting who are bubbling under the surface at all times, and we get tiny little glimpses when they're alone of them starting to erupt, and then they must push back down. And I think that's kind of the makeup of Lauren. I mean, she's always... People are just beat up on this poor woman. I mean, she's the boss, and people are always beating up on her. She is kind of having to solve everyone's problem, pull Kate out of her mess all the time.
Right.
And we get a couple little glimpses where my character starts to lose it, and then she takes a deep breath, and she's got to stuff it back down. So I think the interesting thing to watch for the audience is going to be, when's that top going to blow? Because nobody can be that put together at all times. And that was a wonderful reference that you made. I think that's pretty good, the Joan Crawford reference.
Well, that's, it's she quite frequently was, there was always something underneath. I mean, think about like Mildred Pierce or whatever else, where she had to keep everything going for everybody else's sake.
Right.
And she was, had to give up many things for herself, and that's what it seems like Lauren has to do,
Sure.
And I would be interested in seeing, as the series goes, if there's anybody is going to be able to get through there to her and kind of get through the armor.
And I hope so. And I hope that we, right now, in the beginning of the series, I'm still mourning the death of my husband.
Right.
And so she's sort of dealing with all of that on top of now being the managing partner, on top of all of this. And I'm hoping as the series goes on, that there can be, whether it's a love or a friend or her mom comes to visit, I don't know, something that we really get to see her just really warm up.
Well, I mean, she's in such put in such a defensive position. Is she
definitely
really justified to be there? Mm-hmm. She married into this.
Exactly.
That kind of thing. And so
she's incredibly smart and incredibly capable. I mean, that's what I love about her, is that she's brilliant, and she is justified to be there. Has she had enough experience to be there? Perhaps not. But she's going to do everything in her power to convince everyone around her that she is deserving. Does she question it sometimes? Does she get scared when she's at home? Absolutely.
Cool. Well, I look forward to seeing you develop it more.
Thank you so much, Thomas. I appreciate it.
Pleasure to talk to you.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.